So I'll take a pack.
We have a 2090 programmer.
We also have an ultrasound unit.
In total, 200 pounds of equipment that we'll be hauling in.
Well, the wildlife research started 25 years ago. Tim Lasky, I'm Vice President of Research and Business Development within the Cardiac Ablation Solutions business. On the side, I am an adjunct assistant professor at the University of Minnesota. I'm focused largely on wildlife research. The initial idea came from the University of Wyoming. They had a PhD student that was chartered with developing an implantable heart logger, and the student quit. And I was out there visiting, and of course, with the background at Medtronic, it's what we do. And they asked, by any chance, could Medtronic help with an implantable data logger?
We started with this version.
The first loggers were quite large, and all the devices but one were rejected. But we gathered remarkable information from those, and for the first time saw what the heart rhythms were in a hibernating bear.
So we basically just listened for the strongest signal finder as we go.
So we located where the bear is. We just take a small crew in, and then tranquilizer with a stick. With a syringe on the end.
Can you free a paw?
I got both paws.
Okay, I'm gonna pass the rope.
Go ahead.
The bear's welfare is the number one requirement to make sure the bear is healthy, safe.
The cubs are awfully cute.
The research has two different areas of focus for the bears. One is trying to understand hibernation physiology and potential applications in human medicine. The other aspect relates to conservation. Our current research is focused on the use of the link.
Okay, you can bring it in.
She has two implanted link devices. Tim will download the data that we've got for the last year and check the battery life.
All right, it's loading. That's good.
This particular device gives us the average heart rate every 2 minutes. It tells us subcutaneous temperature. Posture, activity.
She had a lot of episodes in the summer where her heart rate was high.
The most remarkable thing that we learned was that during hibernation, their heart rates are quite low. Periods up to 30 seconds without a heartbeat. A human would faint typically after 6 seconds.
230 beats per minute, 240 beats per minute. On July 4th, that might have been fireworks possibly.
With the bear research, we have been very much focused on writing journal articles. And the Smithsonian called.
We came across a publication by Dr. Lask, that is this famous paper, I love it, that shows the reaction of a female bear in the wild when she is approached by a drone.
The bears wouldn't react to the drone, and the bear didn't appear to be terribly disturbed during these encounters. But what we found by looking at the heart monitor was their heart rate would go from 40 beats per minute to 150 beats per minute when the drone arrived.
When I saw that data, I just envisioned all the possibilities that we could do with a tool like that.
The Smithsonian cold called me and they asked if I would be interested in collaborating, to which I said, yes, yes, absolutely. Are you kidding me?
From that meeting, we started planning the whole thing. One of the animals that we are studying is the largest canid in Brazil and in South America, what we call maned wolf.
And scimitar-horned oryxes.
It's a species from the north of the Africa.
And the oryxes were extinct in the wild. The collaboration with the Smithsonian has been really eye-opening. One of the reasons you may not have heard of these species is there are very few of them.
I called project the rhythm of life because we want to use a heart monitor that can tell us what is the rhythm of life inside. It's very beneficial to people to think of the heart of the animal responding also to emotions like we do. And that, I think it's, on the long term, will help to generate like another generation of conservationists.
This is cardiac ultrasound. We got the mitral valves, so that's the chamber. I'll store that. You can see the papillaries.
Our hope is that this early work we've done and the interest from other researchers around the world will help fuel this look at the physiology and better understand what leads to better quality of life. If we talk about trying to improve quality of life for our patients, we want quality of life for all species on the planet.
Today went extremely well. A very healthy female bear with three beautiful cubs. And so she's going back into the den now.
Ready?
We think that the conservation physiology could be the biggest impact and taking management of wildlife to a completely new level.
All right, ready guys?
Yep.